Hey there, Seth from macOS 10, screencast.com here. This is my screencast about my favorite TextMate features. You see that I have already created this document. This is a standard blog post from our website about VoodooPad, the text editor. This blog post is written in Markdown, and to get us started, I will do some very amazing stuff like dropping a picture from the desktop to TextMate's editing field. TextMate will not explode when you drop the image onto TextMate. It will give you the possibility to enter a name for this picture, and then when you go to the live web preview in the menu bar, you see that it has inserted this picture for you. You can pipe this selected text only through Markdown, the Perl script, which will then give you the output of the Markdown Perl, and you can then customize this a little more, float left, and then when I go back to the web preview, you see that the text is being on the right now and my icon is floating on the left. We can do some very awesome stuff like creating lists. I've set my character to be right in front of the C character. Then hold down the shift key and move the selection downwards. Once you have reached the endpoint of your selection, push the option button once. TextMate will then switch to the so-called columnar selection mode, and then you can insert text which is being displayed in front of each line. We have Markdown syntax, so this makes no sense here. I will use the star characters, and now we have this little list in front of this text. This doesn't look very good, I know. But for demoing purposes, it's okay, I suppose. The next cool thing about TextMate is creating so-called snippets. Snippets are pretty cool. They insert a lot of text in your document, but they have a little intelligence. You can tell TextMate with a special syntax. In this case, it's $ and a number where you want the cursor to be when you press the Tab key or when you press Shift Tab. I will show you this before getting into detail with tab stops too much. I just entered my abbreviation for this snippet. I have set this one to be APPI. Hit the Tab key, and then you see that a bunch of text is being inserted. I then can go one tab stop forwards and one tab stop backwards by pressing the Tab key. I already done some work here at the end of this document, so we'll use this for our document. The next cool thing about TextMate is, let's assume you want to insert an internet address in your document. You normally just go to your web page, copy text or the URL to the clipboard. It doesn't matter if it's beginning with HTTP or with www. It is only to be on the clipboard. Copy it to the clipboard now. Select some text, Control W, and go to the hyperlink helper, which will, once it's activated, insert an HTML link or a link, a hyperlink, how the currently used syntax says a link should look like. In this case, we have square brackets followed by round brackets, an HTTP followed by double quotes text. Markdown syntax says we have square brackets. When we switch to HTML and select this VoodooPad text and then reactivate our hyperlink helper, you see that it has inserted the same link but now HTML formatted. You can use both in Markdown, but we will stick with Markdown syntax for this demo here. Okay, let's move on to the next part of the screencast. I really, really like the bundle which name is TaskMate. Just Google it and it's just awesome. This is cool because you can use it to edit your to-dos. New projects are being declared by entering some text in a line and then press the colon character. And new tasks are being created with a minus character at the beginning of a line. Record a screencast. New tasks are being created with holding down the Option key while pressing Return. Record some more screencasts. What I really like about TextMate is the auto-completion feature, which is being activated by hitting the Escape key. This will scan the current document for text you have already entered and insert it just before your text cursor. You can toggle these tasks by hitting Function Option Return, and I've written my own TextMate command, which is here. This one's called Task is Done. This will execute some little terminal script, which will grab the current line and move it to my archive.txt file, so I can get rid of all the tasks I have already done. Okay, now the last part of this screencast is this small LaTeX document. This will show you how TextMate works together with other applications. LaTeX is really cool for this to show, because you can set in LaTeX preferences what PDF you want to use. You can choose between TextMate itself, Skim, TechniScope, Preview, TextShop, and PDF View. But I will stick with Preview because Leopard's Preview is really, really cool. Most people don't know that it's cool, but it is. I will use the tab trigger sec, which inserts the first section here, sectioning sec, and this one's really cool because it will it shows you how TextMate handles multiple so-called tab stops. And now in the last part of the screencast, I will show you how you use TextMate to calculate things. I go inside the introduction, insert an expression, hit Shift Control C, which will give me a list of options I can choose from. Just hit 1 to evaluate the current line, or if you want to replace your expression, hit 2. Oh, and here's another typical task for TextMate. You can't just insert text and move it around by copying it to the clipboard and pasting it in and so on. You can move it, or you can indent your currently line with a shortcut. This is command square brackets. This works for multiple lines as well. You can, this is pretty cool, you can move selected text left, right, up, down by going to the menu bar. And here you have inside the text menu line up, down, column left, column right. And this enables you to move your text to almost anywhere you want. It's even impossible to move lines up and down. This is pretty cool for lists and stuff where you want to emphasize some things. And this shortcut enables you to move them to the beginning of the list. This was it for this TextMate screencast. I hope you like this program now. I hope you love this program now. And see you next time. Bye bye.